Everybody, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use DALL-E in order to do several things. First of all, I'm going to show you how you can replace specific areas in the image if you generated a really cool image, but part of it you don't like, if you want to replace it with something else, I'll show you how to do it. Another thing is that it's related to the first idea, is that it allows you to fill up areas with Midjourney taking into account the entire image that you are actually using. So if you want, for example, you generated 16:9 and you want to create a square and you have a transparent gap and you want this gap to be filled with content, you can do this in DALL-E as well. I could see in the fact that you already have an account, if not create one, and go to labs.openai.com. As you can see, you already generated an image with transparent pixels on the side, all right? In order to do this in Photoshop, I'm going to show you this in a moment, and basically I need to describe at the prompt what's exactly in the image, all right? So I'm giving a description what's in the image, and then what I need to do is just generate the image, and DALL-E will actually fill in the gap that was transparent pixels with content awareness of actually what's in the image. So basically it also takes into account what's in the image and fills in the gap. I get different options there, all right? It actually did a very, very good job there. It looks incredible, all right? And you can, of course, choose the one that you want, and you can even choose and create a variation of that specific one that you like to create even more variation of a single one that you picked, all right? You can see at the top right corner, variations. All right, so first of all, before we continue with more examples, let me show you how you can do that. So the thing is, right now, it doesn't allow you to bring images of, well, real people, so faces, but there is a workaround it. So what you can do is actually delete just the face, so it will be regenerated when you upload the image. But let's say that I have this one and I want to create, I'm going to go and choose, oh, by the way, before that we need to go to background, double click it, new layer, and click OK. All right, after we do that, we go to image, canvas size, all right, and if I want to be square, I just put the same height. And now you can see that I have both at the top, right? I have spaces here, all right? I can even delete, by the way, delete this one, or delete this area, and I can bring this one into DALL-E, and it will just fill in those gaps. Now, if again, you want to, for example, just change the clothing and other stuff, you can do this inside DALL-E. You don't need to do this in Photoshop, all right? But when it comes to uploading faces, because right now it doesn't work, this workaround just getting override this by just deleting the image. You just go and choose the eraser tool and you can just erase the face. So basically there's no identification here, all right? You can do this as well here, all right? So let me show you more examples, all right? And by the way, you save this one, you do Control Alt S, all right? And you save this as PNG, all right? PNG. And this will save this with transparency, all right? But you need to make sure transparency is turned on. If it's not on, right, now it's going to be white. If I click transparency, it's going to save it with transparency. So make sure you save it with transparency and then click save. Now, after you bring an image, you can click crop, all right? And after that, you click edit image. And again, this is inside DALL-E. This allows you to continue modifying the image. Then you have the option to just draw over and create transparency spaces. So basically use the eraser tool in order to erase the spaces. You can also limit, by the way, the area that is actually applying the generation on. And when I click it, generate, it will generate the area of the face, of course. And again, depends on the prompt that I type, but I just give a quite accurate description of what's in the image. And then you're going to see the face actually being generated there. I prefer mine, but again, it just show you how it works. And this allows you, by the way, to replace eyes or other areas that you don't like or any other thing in the image that you want to be replaced. So it gives you a great degree of control after you already generated an image to continue working on specific parts and changing them. All right, this is another image that I brought. I'm just going to crop it. But basically, if I want to change the clothing, let's say you generated a portrait of women and you want to just change your clothing to something else. Maybe it's a yellow coat, maybe it's a suit, you know, whatever you like, you can change it. So basically, if I want to do it, I just need to override the clothing and delete them. All right, so just for this demonstration, I'm just going to delete the entire clothing. Keep in mind, of course, the end posture, everything else will be generated again. So you might get a different posture, which I'm going to show you in a moment. All right. And again, give description, the more accurate, the better. Or if you just want to replace it with something else, again, just change it to something else, right? But if you want something very, very close to what you already generated, you can do this as well. Again, it's up to you to decide how you want to go with it. So now it's going to generate, give you several thumbnails. And again, I can choose one and continue working with it. I just gave a yellow coat or something. And basically, that's what I got. Yellow clothing. Right? Cool, huh? It's also aware of the different other effects that were in the picture. So it really blends in nicely. So yeah, it's up to you to decide what you want to do. This is also good for areas where it kind of screwed up. You already got a really nice, for example, portrait, and you want to change the color of the eyes or change anything. You want to put makeup, whatever you want. You just delete the area and just describe it in a way, and DALL-E will actually create something with it. I can just choose the eyes. I can even, by the way, use the size of the brush, change it. So you can see on the right, you can change the size of the brush, so you have more fine-tune of the area you're actually deleting. And again, you can even limit the area, so one area actually won't, some of the areas won't actually be affected by it. So as you can see, you can have the option to add an image and also play with the area that actually affects the generation. And yeah, just generate and watch the magic happens. So in this case, I just did it to the face and I got different ones generated. Of course, if you give different descriptions, it will do that, something else. It's up to you to be more precise with what you want and let the AI do its thing. And yeah, it works amazingly well. So I definitely recommend trying that, really amazingly well. Sometimes it doesn't do a great job, depends. And again, play with it until you get what you want. But overall, I'm very pleased with the result that I got. And this gives me kind of an extra thing to use on the process of creating things, whether with DALL-E or just bringing my own images. And thus toying around with things, the more tools I have, the more creative I can be with the result, the more control I have with the result. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this one. Consider leaving a like. More coming. I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.